Then these spectral lines are approaching nearer to each other. This is a spectral series. These are the spectral series observed by the Jacob Balmer in the year 1885, and he is the Swedish teacher. That 1 by lambda is equal to r into 1 by 2 square minus 1 by n square. This r is a Rydberg constant, 1.097 into 10 to the power of 7 meter inverse. This is the spectral series observed by the Balmer. Now, we studied already J.J. Thomson atomic model and Rutherford atomic model. Here, in this Rutherford atomic model, the electrons revolving around the nucleus, and when these electrons are revolving around the nucleus, and this Rutherford experiment studied by the Bohr, and now Bohr atomic model, Bohr atomic model of an atom. Here, according to this, Bohr studied the experiment of the Rutherford, and in the year 1913 he gave the Bohr atomic model. Here, according to this Bohr scientist, here if the electron is revolving around the nucleus, then this electron is accelerated. That accelerated electron continuously loses its energy. Here, if the electron loses its energy, and that electron spiral into the nucleus, spiral and fall into the nucleus. Here, if this is the electron revolving around the nucleus, then here continuously it loses its energy, then this spiral into the nucleus and falling into the nucleus. But it is not happened. And this thing is explained by the Bohr. Here, according to this Bohr atomic model of an atom, here he gave three postulates. Here he gave three postulates. In that, first one, here the electrons revolving around the nucleus. Here the electrons revolving around the nucleus in the stationary orbits. Here, stationary orbits. In these stationary orbits, the electrons can have some definite energy. Here they can have some definite total energy. Here these are called stationary orbits. And when an electron is revolving around the nucleus, then the angular momentum, the angular momentum of an electron is a integral multiple of nh by 2 phi. Here this is angular momentum is equal to nh by 2 pi. That is integral multiple of h by 2 pi, and this n is equal to 1, 2, 3 and so on. Here this angular momentum is quantized. The angular momentum of electron is quantized. And when the electron, and one more third postulate, according to this third postulate, when the electron is exciting from higher energy level to lower energy level, then it can emit the radio photon of energy. Here the electron is coming from this higher energy, this EI minus EF, then it can emit the energy, that is a photon. Here EI, the energy of the initial level, is greater than the energy of the final level, then it can emit the photon of energy h nu. This is the third postulate. Here there are three postulates given by the Bohr, that is the stationary orbits, the electrons revolving around the particular orbits which have a definite total energy, and angular momentum of an electron, that is a mvr. This angular momentum of an electron, mvr, is equal to nh by 2 pi. N is equal to 1, 2, 3 and so on. Here ei minus EF is equal to H nu. That means if an electron takes the transition from higher energy level to lower energy level, then the photon of energy is emitted. These are the three postulates given by the Bohr. Now, here according to this Bohr's second postulate, now we have the angular momentum of an electron is a integral multiple of nh by 2 pi, where this h is called a Planck's constant. That value is 6.625 into 10 to the power of minus 34 joule second. 6.625 into 10 to the power of minus 34 joule second. This value, this is the Planck's constant. Now, according to this, we can write the velocity value. Already, when I explained this electron orbits, already we have equation for that. That is mv square by r is equal to e square by 4 pi epsilon naught into r square. Now if we cancel this r, this is rn, okay, nth orbit radius rn, then we can write the, by this we can write rn is equal to, this rn is equal to e square by 4 pi epsilon naught into mv square. Now I am substituting this rn value into this equation, then mvn into e square by 4 pi epsilon naught into mv square is equal to nh by 2 pi. Now this one here v and vn gets cancelled, then here m gets cancelled, then we'll get e square by 4 pi epsilon naught into vn is equal to nh by 2 pi. Here e square by 4 pi epsilon naught into vn is equal to nh by 2 pi we got. Here this Vn value, if we substitute this Vn value into again this equation, then we'll get a m into this Vn value I'm substituting here, that is a Vn is equal to e square by 4 pi epsilon naught into we'll get a 2 pi by nh. This Vn value I'm substituting into this equation 2, then rn is equal to e square by 4 pi epsilon naught into m into 1 by vn square we have. That means here we'll get a this 4 pi epsilon naught whole square by e power 4 into this nh whole square by 2 pi whole square will get. That means here 4 pi epsilon naught, 1 4 pi epsilon naught gets cancelled, then here we'll get a e square and here vn is equal to e square by 4 pi epsilon naught into 2 pi by nh we have. This vn value I'm substituting into this equation, then we'll get a m into this vn value e square by 4 pi epsilon naught into 2 pi by nh is equal into rn is equal to nh by 2 pi. Now by this rn is equal to nh by 2 pi whole square into 4 pi epsilon naught by e square m.